My name's Steve Butler. I'm Senior Industry Strategy Manager with Autodesk. And today, I'm here with Daniel. Daniel, do you want to introduce yourself?
Sure, I'm Daniel Stonecipher, Vice President and Chief Product Officer of eCAD for Energy Management Software at Schneider Electric.
So I'm excited to be here today with you to talk about your new product. Can you tell me a little bit about the motivation behind that? What is it? Why are you doing it?
We found a need to increase or add value to the existing electrical design tools that Autodesk already has in the Revit platform. We find many customers that are looking for these advanced code-based, standard-based electrical design and analysis tools that are kind of missing today in the BIM environment and across the energy management and new energy landscape sort of portfolio.
I guess when we look at the industry and we look at sort of what's happening, trends around building electrification, you know, adoption of BIM, do you think that the lack of these capabilities is what's maybe kept the electrical professionals behind and maybe not moving so quickly towards BIM?
Yeah, absolutely. And there's this movement towards electricity 4.0, right? And again, the new energy landscape. So traditionally, there's been this mechanical engineering space that's defined, right? What is high-performance building design, energy efficiency based off of the buildings and the envelope design. But what we're really talking about is how does electricity start to play a major decision in the earlier stages? How are we influencing the overall building design by having smarter decisions, by being able to analyze sooner not just only electrical distribution systems, but also the new energy landscape? How do we include PV arrays? How do we include control centers and do what-if scenarios at the earlier stages?
So you really, I guess, it sounds like addressing two problems, like today's immediate problems of how do these people, you know, get better tools in their hand to meet regional standards and codes and things, and then the future as well. So it gives them something to sort of move into going forward. It gives them the tools they need to really sort of specify for the new energy landscape.
Yeah, absolutely. So this is all about how are we future-proofing our collective customers and clients, as well as their clients, the downstream customer that's really looking to optimize their energy efficiency within their buildings. And where does that begin, right? It either begins at how are we advancing an existing building and their design? How are we retrofitting that? What's the analysis behind it to the greenfield design as well?
Wow. Fantastic. You mentioned the new energy landscape and electricity 4.0 earlier. Perhaps I could ask you to just expand a little bit on that, and what exactly does that mean for people that maybe are not so familiar with those terms?
Sure. So a new energy landscape is really talking about how are we bringing these distributed energy resources to bear, and how are we looking at them from an analytical sense with the same design purpose that building envelope and siting and orientation has really been considered. So how are we analyzing the physical location of the site? How are we defining what those distributed energy resources might be? Are they a PV array? Are they wind? Are they solar? What would be the control center? How would they connect to a battery backup or an uninterrupted power supply? And then how are we doing analysis on that? So similar to some of the other great analysis tools from Autodesk, being able to do 365-day analysis on a location to determine what is the viability of this new energy landscape, this new distributed energy resource, and bring that back to the customer in ways that have tangible business results. But again, really focused on those types of alternative energy resources and how do we integrate that into both greenfield and brownfield project design.
Yeah, amazing. So this isn't just about electrical design anymore, this is about sustainability and everything linked back with that. Let's talk a little bit about the partnership. What does the partnership mean for Schneider?
Well, we were mentioning earlier, right, the two leading companies, I think we're number three and four most sustainable companies in the world. So with Autodesk's one of the leading BIM platforms, it makes a whole lot of sense for us to be able to take these tools and attach it and bring it to this combined customer base that are looking for these same things, that are looking for these design tools to help them address carbonization, decarbonization, energy management. So for this large, at scale, mature enterprise, you know, giant software company for us to connect with, the same scale of what we have. It's really enticing and it makes a lot of sense. What does this partnership mean to you, Steve?
If you look at the history of Revit, we started off, I think, version one with the electrical capabilities we had until last year, I think, when we revisited it and started to look at how we could advance, this, as I said earlier, the sort of concept design stage of it, both to match where we are mechanically within Revit in terms of system design, but also to support the partnership, right? Trying to find what it is we can do to help you. But I think from the most exciting thing for us for the partnership is bringing your industry knowledge, Schneider's industry knowledge, to this partnership and enabling us to really tackle electrical design in ways that I don't think we could have done it and haven't done it before. So as you say, it's a great marriage, really.
Yeah, and that's a great point. So again, on our side, the years in the history of manufacturing and then having to support that manufacturing, right? And the years in the history of developing software and cutting edge software to lead, right? In this BIM environment, it makes sense for us to come together. And there's a lot of value for the customer out of that.
We see our customers use a variety of our tools depending on the size of the company, depending on the size of, and complexity of the project. What you've mentioned already sounds really exciting, really sophisticated and quite comprehensive, which is great. Do you think that's really aimed more at the enterprise account, or will it meet even the needs of the smaller firm?
Yeah, absolutely. This is advanced electrical design for all, right? That's our mantra, and low voltage, medium voltage design. Absolutely. So the design tools can be used at any stage of conceptual up to detailed design, no matter the size of the project. We stay within the traditional building segments, but within that space, this tool is intended for small, medium, large companies.
So, you know, Revit's got electrical design capabilities. It's had them from the beginning, in fact. And, you know, Autodesk have recently gone back and we've started to sort of refocus in that area and try and sort of readdress the balance, as you say, between mechanical and electrical by enhancing the electrical sort of capabilities. But I mean, I guess we've been doing it more at a sort of conceptual early sort of design stage. From what you're doing, it sounds more like it's pulling that further downstream. Would that be a fair sort of summary?
Yeah, absolutely. If you look at Schneider and the decades of experience on the hardware and the manufacturing side,
right,
we have this wealth of knowledge of how does this equipment actually operate in the field? What is its lifetime cycles? How does it get replaced? When does it need to be replaced? And how do you design for those types of scenarios across low and medium voltage systems?
So it's really making Revit and I guess ultimately other sort of platform capabilities from Autodesk were very much extensible and more comprehensive. Yeah, that's fantastic. But when we spoke a little while ago, you mentioned that you're actually embracing other manufacturers' equipment and trying to get them onto your platform as well, is that correct?
Yeah, I'm glad you brought that up, right? Because Autodesk, the Revit platform, is an agnostic platform. And as such, our tools building onto that platform, with that platform, in that platform, need to be agnostic. So whether it's Schneider equipment or any of our major competitors' equipment, when we start talking about data catalogs and availability of information and equipment for sizing and selection, all of that will be available through the platform agnostically.
I guess the ultimate question is, where do you think this is going to take the industry? What's going to come off the back of this partnership? We talked about the exciting things it's going to do as we develop the next couple of years' worth of releases, but looking into the future and what's happening, like you mentioned, around building electrification, do you think this is really going to help move the industry forward?
Yeah, absolutely. So with data and these connections of data across multiple software platforms, and the ability to start utilizing additional tools like machine learning or AI to do what-if scenarios, to do design validations, to be able to do these things in the time frame and at the pace and with the complexity that more advanced buildings that are addressing, you know, the today's climate changes and those systems designs need. So I see us moving forward in that direction, being able to further assist the customer to make better decisions to use their body of knowledge and their experience utilizing the tool to enhance that knowledge, right? So to advance those tools in ways that allow them to provide the best benefit and the best look forward.
So Daniel, you talked a lot about sort of your technology in Revit, but I know you're actually looking beyond that, right? You're looking at cloud technology, you're looking at Forge. Can you talk a little bit about that?
It makes sense for us to continue in our partnership. Autodesk has invested quite heavily in their cloud platform. We are as well. To be able to provide that more efficient, kind of fileless, accessible information and data really anywhere, to take advantage of cloud computing, all of those benefits and resources. So as a result of this partnership, we formed BIM Electrical Corp, right, to house and take care of the solution. That's where customers will engage and be able to be supported and buy their product from.
So BIM Electric Corp is a subsidiary of Schneider Electric?
Yes, it is.
Oh, okay, great.
Yeah. Specifically focused on this partnership. So we needed to make sure, that we maintain this agnostic ability. So for us to be able to present a brand as an output or a result of our partnership. So we're really excited about where Autodesk is going with their cloud platform, and it enables us to attach our platforms to this.
And that's great to hear. You know, we're intentionally moving to the cloud, creating a platform, you know, really to sort of open things up and become less closed, more open through partnerships, alliances. You know, this sort of alliance we have is just the beginning of many more. But I'm really excited about what we're doing together and the technology we're producing, and I'm pretty sure our customers will be as well.
Yeah, I echo that sentiment. We couldn't be more happy to be partnered with you.
Absolutely. Well, it was great speaking to you today, Daniel. Thanks for being here, and I really look forward to seeing where this goes.
Same here, Steve. Thank you so much.